Okay, today we'll start the unit 2. So in first unit we have discussed the DC circuits. In the second unit we will discuss the AC circuits. Before going to the AC circuits, we should know some quantities. What are those quantities in AC circuits? We should know. See here. First one is So I had to discuss three quantities. One is instantaneous value, second one average value, third one RMS value. RMS value is also called as effective value. We should know these three. If you want to discuss about the AC quantities, we should know these three values. Then only it is easy for understanding the AC. AC means alternating current. DC means direct current. AC means alternating current. What is the difference between DC and AC? What is the difference
between direct current?
Okay, in DC we are having only magnitude, but in AC we are having both magnitude and angle. In DC we are having only magnitude, but in AC we are having both magnitude and angle. Angle means phase angle. Okay, that is the difference between DC and AC. Now, before going to AC, we'll see what is instantaneous value. Can anyone tell what do you mean by instantaneous, general meaning?
Okay.
Instantaneous means?
A particular point.
Sudden, like that, okay?
Sudden, spot.
Instantaneous, spontaneous, immediate. That is called instantaneous value. First, I'll define instantaneous value. See, Sayadi. Instantaneous value. I'll take the example of sine wave. I'm taking the example of sine wave. See here. On x-axis, I am taking omega t. X is equal to omega t. On y-axis, I am taking sine omega t. Okay, sine function I am taking. Here, independent variable is omega t. Dependent variable is y, that is sine omega t. Now, let us take omega t is equal to 0. Omega t is equal to 30. T is equal to 45. 60. 90. Okay. write on this. What is root 3 by 2 value? All these are the instantaneous values. At omega t is equal to 0, this is 1 point instantaneous value. Omega is equal to 30, 1 instantaneous value. 45, 1 instantaneous value. 60, 1 instantaneous value. If you take single point, that is called instantaneous value. Remember, if you take at each and every point, is the instantaneous value. Instead of y, let us take voltage on y-axis. Instead of y, take it as voltage. Or current you can. I is equal to Im into sine. If you take current, you will get Im. Have you written this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see here. Here, if I take voltage, I am taking Vm is the maximum voltage. Vm is called peak value. Vm is called peak value. Suppose if I take current, I will take I is equal to Im into sine omega t. If you take power, maximum power into sine omega t. So see here, this V is called instantaneous voltage. That is small v, small I, small p. All these are the instantaneous values. Instantaneous value defined as, left side it is instantaneous value. Instantaneous value is equal to peak value into trigonometric function. Peak value into trigonometric function. It is defined as, write down, instantaneous value is equal to, instantaneous value is equal to peak value into trigonometric function. I am defining the instantaneous value as is equal to peak value. Peak value means maximum value. Peak value means maximum value. Peak value means maximum value into trigonometric function. Suppose if I take V here, in place of y, I am taking instantaneous value. 0 into Vm. Now I am taking Vm is equal to 1. When you will get, now take only V. small v. Small v is called instantaneous value, that is equal to peak value is maximum value sine omega t. Sine omega t is the trigonometric function. Now see here, what is sine zero?
Zero.
Zero. Sin 0 is 0. Here I am taking. Sin 30 is 0.5. Sin 30 is 0.5. Sin 45 is the instantaneous value. What is the value? 0.707. 0.707 means here I am taking. Sin 90 is 1. Sin 90 is 1. 1 is the peak value. 1 is the peak value. Next is sin, after sin 90, sin 120. Sin 120 is sin 0. Sin 60 I have not taken. Okay. Sin 60 is 0. Here 60 is there. Okay. Sin 90 is 1. Sin 90 is 1. Peak value you will get at sin 90. Sin 120 is again 0.86. 0.86. Sin 180 is 0. Sin 180 is 0. Next is sin 1. Sin 270. Sin 270 is 270 is minus 1. Sin 360 is 0. Now join all these instantaneous values. 0 at 0, 1 instantaneous, 30 degrees, 1 instantaneous value. 45 degrees, 1 instantaneous value. 60, 1 instantaneous, 90. Now join all these instantaneous values. We will get average value. Join all these instantaneous values. We will get sine curve. Join all the instantaneous values, we'll get the sine curve. So now the formula for the instantaneous value is, here the peak value is 1, you see. Vm is 1. See, peak value is 1. Sine omega t. Now substitute omega t any value here, we'll get instantaneous values. Substitute omega t is equal to any value, we'll get the instantaneous values. So instantaneous value, the formula is defined as peak value into trigonometric function. Remember this, we will be using in the entire second unit. This instantaneous value defined as peak value. Peak value means maximum value into trigonometric function. Here the maximum value, see, at 90 degrees you are getting. Okay, sine 0, 0 plus 90, 90 plus 180, 180 plus 90, 270 plus 90 is 360. For every 90 degrees, the value is 0 at sine 0, 0. Sine 90, 1. Sine 180, it is 0. Again, 180 plus 90, it is 270. Sine 270 minus 1. 270 plus 90, 360. Sine 360, 0. All these are the, if you join all these instantaneous values, we'll get sine curve. This is the first formula. Now see, instantaneous value is defined as small v is equal to maximum voltage into trigonometric function. Suppose if you take sine wave, the trigonometric function is sine wave. If you take cos wave, the trigonometric function is cos omega t. So depending upon our input, if it is cos wave, trigonometric function will take cos wave. If it is sine wave, we'll take sine wave, trigonometric function. But in the instantaneous value, there should be peak value into trigonometric function. This is formula one. Next, second one. Average value. V average. Second formula, average value. How will get average value? See, average value is defined as 1 by total time period. See here, total time period is here, what is the time period of one cycle here in this diagram? What is the total time period of one cycle? Okay, listen.
Five.
No, that is half cycle.
2 pi.
One cycle means one positive and negative cycle. Here, the upper one is positive cycle, the other one is the negative cycle. This is positive cycle, this is negative cycle. One positive and negative cycle combinedly, we'll call it as one cycle. Next one is, this is second cycle. From 2 pi to 4 pi, 2 pi to 4 pi is the second cycle. See, cycle is repeating. The first cycle is repeating. That's why we will take only for one cycle. One cycle means positive and negative cycle. So total time period of one cycle is 2 pi. Half cycle means 0 to pi. Half cycle means 0 to pi. One cycle means combination of positive and negative cycle. Okay, we are into the next advanced layer. Okay. Combination of one positive and negative cycle is called one cycle. Now here, if you take the average, here 1 by 2 pi, what is the initial limit? Initial value for one cycle?
Zero.
It is 0.
Zero.
Final value? 2 pi. What is the instantaneous value there?
0.
This is the instantaneous value. Instantaneous value is equal to Vm sin. Vm is peak value into trigonometric function. This is your instantaneous value. So this is the average value. In this way, if you know the instantaneous value, then only I can determine the average value. If I know the, tell me. If I know the instantaneous value, I can determine the average value. That's why first I had defined the instantaneous value. This instantaneous value is V. In place of V, you can substitute Vm sin omega. In place of instantaneous value, you can substitute Vm sin omega. So our first condition is we have to determine instantaneous value. Up to this, clear? Next, we will go for the RMS value. This is the formula for average value. Next, I will go for the RMS value. See here, for RMS value, we'll take squares. We'll take squares on both sides. In average value, we are taking linear value. Power is 1. But in RMS value, we'll, formula is same. Only the difference is we'll take squares. Here I will take square. Here also I will take square. RMS value square is equal to 1 by total time period. Integral of initial value, initial limit to final limit. Instantaneous value whole square d omega t. RMS means root mean square. Root mean square or effective value. Root means, why it is called root mean square means, if you bring this square to this side, it becomes square root. If you bring this square to this side, it becomes square root. We are taking the square root of the mean of the square value. Instantaneous value is square. Okay, RMS, root mean square. We are taking the mean of this by taking the integral. If you are taking the integral of the square, that is mean square. And finally, you are taking root. That's why it is called root mean square. The difference between average and RMS value is, there we are taking power 1. But here we are taking square. That is the only difference. The formula, remaining formula, everything is same. Otherwise, you can bring this square to this side. That is root mean square. That's all. That is the only difference between average and RMS value. Only squares are taken. Write down this formula for RMS value. So these three formulas you should know. Now we'll go for the problems on these three. Instantaneous value, average value, and RMS value. Have you studied half-way rectifier in plus 2, full-way rectifier in plus 2?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think you have already derived the formulas for a half-way rectifier and full-way rectifier, average value and RMS value. Same thing we'll derive here now. I'll derive the average value and RMS value. For the half-way rectifier, first I'll take half-way rectifier. Then I'll go for the full-way rectifier. See you. Half-way rectifier setting. Here, this is the AC source. This is the circuit symbol for the AC. That is the circuit symbol for AC. Tell me. Okay. Here, this is the circuit symbol for AC. AC means on x-axis I am taking omega t, On y axis, I am taking the instantaneous voltage V. On y axis, I am taking the instantaneous voltage V. Okay. Now here, I am drawing the input voltage. See, the input voltage is V is equal to Vm sin omega t. We are having both positive cycle and negative cycle. Draw this. Okay, see here. Sin 90 is 1. Sin 270 is minus 1. Now we are having positive cycle and negative cycle. From 0 to pi, it is positive cycle. Remember? From 0 to pi, I am taking the polarity lines. See the polarity? For AC source, from 0 to pi, the polarity will be like this, positive, negative. From pi to 2 pi, it is minus and plus. From pi to 2 pi, it is minus and plus. Now tell me, in the upper diagram, diode is forward biased or reverse biased? In the upper diagram, diode is forward biased or reverse biased? If anode is positive, then it is forward biased. See here, anode is connected to positive terminal. Anode is connected to positive terminal means your diode is forward biased here. But here, anode is connected to negative terminal. That is reverse biased. In forward biased, diode is short circuited. In forward bias, in forward bias, diode is short circuited. In reverse bias, diode is open circuited. Now see here. What is now current always flows from negative to positive. Current is flowing from negative terminal to positive terminal like this. But here diode is open circuited. In open circuit, the current is zero. In that means from pi to 2 pi, your current is zero. From pi to 2 pi, your current is zero. Your current flows in the circuit only from 0 to pi. Your current flows in the circuit only from 0 to pi, positive cycle. Now tell me the output voltage here. So in the first case, your output voltage is V naught is equal to I into R. In the first case, your output voltage is V naught is equal to I into R. In the second case, what is the output voltage?
Zero.
Your I is zero in the second case. Now I am drawing the output voltage here. So your output voltage is equal to input voltage from 0 to pi. From 0 to pi, your output voltage is 0 to pi. Output voltage is equal to input voltage. Output voltage is equal to input voltage. But during negative cycle, what is the output voltage?
Positive panukonda.
During negative cycle, what is the output voltage?
Zero.
Zero. That's why I'm not drawing anything there. See, in the graph, I'm not drawing the output voltage in the negative cycle. So only for half cycle, you are getting output voltage. That's why it is called as halfway rectifier. And AC is converted to DC here, you see. And your AC is converted to DC. So again in the next cycle, only during positive cycle I will get output voltage. Because why it is happening like this? After positive cycle, the polarity is changing. See, after positive cycle, it is changing the polarity. It is crossing the zero axis and it is entering into the negative cycle. When it is entering into the negative cycle, it is changing the polarity. See, after pi, it is changing the polarity as minus and plus. Now anode is negative. That's why since it is changing the polarity after pi, we are getting output voltage zero. So in the graph, any doubt? From 2 pi to 3 pi, it is positive cycle. We are getting output voltage. Again, from 3 pi to 4 pi, we are not getting output. Polarity is changed, negative cycle. That means it is converting. AC to DC. How can you say that your output voltage is DC? Your input is AC. Positive negative cycle is there. But output is only DC. I am calling it as DC output. Rectifier meaning is it converts AC to DC. Meaning of rectifier is it converts AC to DC. How we can say that V naught is DC? Output voltage is DC. How can you say that output voltage is DC? There are two types of DC. See here. This is DC. This is also a DC. First one is called constant DC. Second one is called pulsating DC. AC means we'll have both positive and negative cycle. But in DC, we'll have only one polarity. See in the second graph, there is one polarity, positive polarity. If you have both the polarities, that is called AC. Please remember, first type is called constant DC. This is called pulsating DC. Please remember, there are two types of DCs. One is called constant DC, and the one is called pulsating DC. See in the second graph, only one polarity is there, positive polarity. If you have only one polarity, that is also called as DC. If you have both the polarities, see in the first graph, this is AC. This is your AC, input is AC. We are having both positive and negative cycle. If you have both positive and negative cycle, that is called AC. If you have only one polarity, that is called DC. That is called DC. Please remember this. Okay, this is the concept. Now we'll go for the derivations of average voltage and RMS voltage for the half wave rectifier. Until now, I have not derived the formulas. Just I have explained the concept of half wave rectifier. Half wave rectifier means only half cycle will get output voltage. In a complete one cycle, I'm getting only half output voltage. Why I'm getting half output voltage means in the negative cycle, your diode is open. In the open circuit, your output voltage is zero. And the output is DC. Why output is DC means we are having only positive cycles. That's why in this way, we are converting AC to DC. This is your AC and this output is DC. Output is DC. Until any doubt up to this?
No, sir.
Then I'll go for derivation. What is the total time period of one cycle?
2 pi.
2 pi. 1 by, see the formula, what I had done, 1 by total time period. Your initial limit, what is the V naught? V naught is V average. Your V naught is V average here. What is the upper limit?
5.
Okay. Your upper limit is 5 because it is 0 here. 0 volts. In the negative cycle, we are not taking 2 pi upper limit because from 0 to 2 pi, I am taking only conducting period. This is called conducting period. This is called non-conducting period. Conducting period from pi to 2 pi, non-conducting period. Okay. In non-conducting period, your voltage is zero. Conducting period plus non-conducting period is equal to total period. Conducting period plus non-conducting period is equal to total period. Total period is 2 pi. Your conducting period is 0 to pi. Your non-conducting period is, non-conducting means your output is zero. In the integral, even if you take from pi to 2 pi, it is 0. There is no need to take from pi to 2 pi. There is no value here. And instantaneous value. Your instantaneous value is Vm sin omega t into d omega t. On x-axis, we are taking omega t. And I am taking with respect to d omega t. X-axis, we are taking omega t and with respect to d omega t. Okay. Now take the average value. Now take the integral. That is Vm is constant, peak value. What is integral of sine omega t?
Minus cos omega t into omega.
minus cos omega t. That's all. If you take with respect here, if we are having dt, we'll get divided by omega. But we are not having dt here. We are having d omega t. If you are having dt, we'll get divided by omega. But we are having d omega t. That's why you won't get divided by omega. Remember this carefully. With respect to d omega t, I am taking. That's why you won't get cos omega t by omega. It is only cos omega. If you are taking with respect to dt, then you'll get divide minus cos omega t by omega. That is Vm by 2 pi minus of cos pi minus cos 0. That is Vm by 2 pi. What is cos pi?
Minus 1.
Okay, minus 1. So this is the average value. In your plus 2 also you have derived this formula. V average is equal to Vm by pi for half way rectifier. So this is the average value. Then you have to derive RMS value for half way rectifier. For RMS, what you'll do?
Root.
We'll take spikes on both sides. For RMS, see the formula what I had told. We'll take squares on both sides. Instantaneous value square on right side. Okay. Now see here. Vm square sin square omega. Vm square. We'll get Vm square. Vm is constant, take outside the integral. What is sin square omega t?
1 minus cos pi.
I am converting the square to linear function. If you are having sin square omega t, you can't apply integral. First convert into linear function. 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2. Now apply the integral. Bring up 2 outside. I am bringing 2 outside. What is integral of 1 into d omega t?
Omega, omega t.
Omega t. What is integral of cos 2 omega t?
Sin 2 omega t by 2.
First, I am substituting the upper limit. What is sine 2 pi?
0.
0. Pi is going to be cancelled. This is the RMS value for half way rectifier. V RMS is equal to Vm by 2. If you want to verify in plus 2 also, you have derived this. same answer you might first get. You can verify. So this is the RMS value.